So help me fill this out. Using your identity sheet, those who have it, somebody call out what sine of A plus B can be rewritten as.
Sine A cosine B plus cosine B sine.
Yes. So if you see a sine A plus B, this is what it turned into. Mr. Smith, how am I supposed to memorize that? You're not. Okay. You'll get better at it, but don't panic. You're going to have this. We just need to know the flow and know where to find them. Okay. Somebody else. It's the second one. What will it turn into?
Sine A cosine B minus cosine B sine A.
Yeah. So the only difference in these first two are if it's a plus, it's a plus. If it's a minus, it's a minus. Okay. Somebody else. The third one. You can read it straight off your identity sheet. What would cosine of A plus B turn into?
Cosine A cosine B minus sine A sine B.
Okay. I know Julia is not the only one who has this. Are we just don't want to talk? I want to make sure as many of us, we at least know where to find these, right? We have this, I hope. Okay, and then the last one, Ethan, you take it.
Yep, cosine A, cosine B, plus sine A, sine B.
Whoops.
There we go.
Do you like that? I turned that C into an F. So you can almost notice, with the sines, it's sine, cos, cosine. With the cosines, it's cos, cos, sine, sine. Okay, there. It's just some patterns that will help you remember them, but again, you don't have to necessarily. Okay, so how do these help us? How do these help us? Moment of truth. I'm calling on you, and you better get this right. Matthew Hillstrom, the sine of zero is?
Zero.
Matthew Perna, sine of 30 is?
One half.
One half. Kaylin Brown, sine of 45 is? Andrew Benz, sine of 60. Harrison Taylor, sine of 90. Tyler Sesfeld, no, you're good.
Chapter 4,
yes, I do.
I'm just going to go over it with them.
Yeah, no problem. You just saved it, now they're going to go study their charter. Because I was calling on it randomly.
Oh, I see. Hmm.
Old trick.
Thank you.
No problem.
Tyler Sesfeld.
Should I say that?
Cosine of zero.
One.
Carly Loss, cosine of 30. Riley Kearney, cosine of 45.
Two.
I'm also working on my first and last names right now. Ethan Oakley, cosine of 60.
One half.
I'm going to struggle with this last name, but let's go EJ Nemchik. Was that right?
Yes.
Nemchik? Nemchik. Let's go. Isabella Tarlac, tangent of zero. We're not looking at our charts, right? We're doing this from memory?
Yeah.
Ty Seeger, tangent of 30.
Root 3/3.
Jimmy Ridge, tangent 45.
One.
Forge Zowell, tangent of 60.
Tangent 60, root 3.
Root 3. And I didn't get everybody, but let's go Caitlin Scafano, tangent of 90.
No answer.
Undefined, no answer. Okay. So, have we ever done one like this? Have we ever done sine of 15 in our life?
Yes.
No. We've only done sine of 30, sine of 45, sine of 60, sine of 90. So here's what we do. It's very easy. Could you pick two of these numbers that could add or subtract to give us 15? Which two? 45 and 30. So why don't we picture this instead of sine of 15? Why don't we picture this as sine of 60 minus 45? And if this is now our A, this is now our B, which of these identities at the top, 1, 2, 3, or 4, will we be using?
Four.
the one that has the minus. And so watch what it's going to turn into. Sine of A, so technically sine of 60, cosine of 45, minus cosine of 60, sine of 45, right? You don't have to memorize that. You just look up at identity number 2 up there, and I converted it.
Is this still going to be the test?
Yeah. So then now, this is where you got to go back. Thank goodness for these Kia quizzes, right, that you guys hate. What's sine of 60? Root 3 over 2. What's cosine of 45? Root 2 over 2. Minus, what's cosine of 60? Yeah, we have our chart. You should be saying this quickly. Look at the chart. What's sine of 45? Yeah, the chart's right there staring at you. Just go off the chart. Okay? So now we have this, and it's just algebra now because it's multiplication. So this times this, square root of 3 times square root of 2 would be what? Square root of 3 times square root of 2 is the square root of 6 over 2 times 2 is 4. And then minus 1 times the square root of 2 is the square root of 2. 2 times 2 is 4. So then from here, it's common denominator, thank goodness. So our final answer is just square root of 6 minus square root of 2 over 4. So what's this first part of the lesson mean? If you see an angle that's not 30, 60, 90, 30, 45, 60, 90 that we're used to, you can use, these are called sum and difference identities. You can use these to set up a little problem like that, that then you can solve. So the sine of 45, or sine of 15, excuse me, is this. So right now, with yourself, by yourself, and then check with a partner, try one with cosine. Which two of these could make cosine? Don't say this out loud, but which two of those could make 105, and which identity would you use? Take a minute to do it and we'll bring it back. When you finish, you can check with me. I went ahead and solved it for those who are absent. I wanted them to be able to not have a bunch of dead time in the video. Yes?
Are you plugging it in the same way as the fractions or the equations on top?
Yep. So notice, technically this was my A and this was my B, right? So up here, cosine of A plus B, that would be number 3.
Would it be minus square root 2 minus square root 6 over 4?
Yeah, it should be minus. You're right.
Okay, so
that's why I have you guys.
No,
number 1, it was a minus because it's sine of 2 things subtracted. And
no, it's sine.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yep.
All right,
cool.
Got it.
Okay.
Why is that minus? That was
messy. If you ever have A plus B, I went up here at A plus B, and it's a minus. I messed that up, too.
Oh.
So with cosine, if you're adding them with cosine, it's a subtraction in the middle, which is kind of strange. But with sine, when you're adding, it's a plus. How do you get that memorized? You don't. You just use it every time and make sure yours matches. Yeah.
I also remember the riddle.
Okay, hold that thought. Later. Okay. Does that make sense? Okay, so flip over. I know this stapling was horrible. I made sure it was hole punched and stapled this time, but it all came out of whack. We've got some proofs. Here's how we're finishing the day. I'm going to show you a couple so you can get the flow of these. These are easy. Last pages, medium and hard. Okay? So let's look at 3, 4, 5, and 6. I'm going to only do two of these. So without even, we're going in blind. Which two do you want me to do? 5 and 6? 5 and 6. Good call. Good call. Okay? So I'm looking at this right here. Today we're doing something new. So does that look familiar? Cosine of something minus something.
Mm-hmm.
Should trigger in your brain cosine of X minus B, mm-hmm. or A minus B. So then we flip back to our identity sheet, and we realize that whenever you have cosine of A minus B, what's the setup going to be? Somebody look at your identity sheet and tell me what the setup is.
Cos A plus B.
Hold on, say it slow, because it's cosine of A, but in this case, our A is an X. So cosine of A, cosine of B, you said?
Yeah.
And in this case, B is a pi, right?
And plus sine A.
Plus sine of A, which is not A, it's actually X.
And sine B.
And sine B, which is pi. So it's the same formula, it's just you can actually use what they give you. You with me? So then this is where unit circle comes in. Cosine of pi. Do we remember cosine of pi? What's cosine of pi? It's cosine of 180. So that's this point right here. The cosine of this point, cosine has to do with x. What's my x value at this point?
Zero.
My y value is zero.
Negative one.
My x value is negative one. So the cosine of pi would be negative one. So this is saying cosine of x times negative one, so that's just negative. Plus, what's sine of pi? What's my y value at this point?
Zero.
I'm zero, I'm not up, I'm not down, I'm at zero. Okay. So sine of pi is zero, so that's just going to cancel that whole thing out, and you just left with negative cosine, which is what we wanted, right? So again, these proofs are easy difficulty. It's just it's a new identity. So it's going to take us a minute to get our sheet and make sure we do it right, but it's not going to be over challenging on this page. Yes?
So why did you cross out the sine x sometime?
Good question. Sine of pi is technically zero. So this time zero would be zero, so I canceled it out. Good question. Sine of pi is zero. Yeah. So I'm hoping if we've been doing the Kia quizzes, the unit circle's not totally gone, but know that'll stay there, so you can do some practice if you need to. And number six. Honestly, you guys can do these. This one is just a normal proof. That doesn't even use anything we did today. This, you're going to be able to do it. Just do the sine of A plus B and the sine of A minus B, and good things will happen. Over here, treat this as an A, treat this as a B, good things will happen. I want to do one of the hard ones because you're going to need more help on those. So let's look at 7 through 10 instead. Or 7, 9, 10, 12. 12, 10.
7, 9, 10, 12.
Yeah. Kind of crazy. Hear me when I say this, because this really, I tried this a few weeks ago, right? I keep telling you I was prepping just to make sure I remembered. I looked at this and had no clue what to do because there's no identity that has sine of 3x. I was like, we have a sine of 2x. I can't remember learning a sine of 3x. And that's because we have to take, if you ever see, this is a rule, golden rule, if you ever see a 3x, a 4x. Right, Hillstrom? You're going to miss this and you're going to be mad at yourself. If you ever see a 3x, a 4x, you have to split it into something like this. The identities we did today. What plus what could equal 3x? 2 and 1. And I believe we do have an identity of sine of 2x and sine of 1x. Those are identities. So if you ever see a 3x, you immediately start on that side. Even though that looks kind of uglier, if you see a 3, it's impossible unless you change it. Look at number 12. The left side looks a lot uglier, but that's a cosine of 3x. We've got to go take care of that. Look at number 9. The right looks way uglier, but we have a sine of 4x, so you've got to take care of that first. Okay? So let's do number 7 together, right? And I just totally boxed myself in this little tiny rectangle, so I'm going to have to write small. And I have to do this in 4 minutes because this video can't go over 20 minutes. Right? So here we go. This is an identity, sine of A plus sine of B. So using my sheet, I look back over it. It turns into sine of A cosine of B plus cosine of A sine of B. That was straight off the identity sheet. Okay? So now I'm looking here, and these are identities. Sine of 2x is an identity. Cosine of 2x is an identity. That shouldn't have a plus sign in it, by the way. Okay? Those are attached. So I'm going to change this sine of 2x to what it needs to change to. 2 cosine sine. That's an identity. Plus, okay, and then cosine of 2x. This is identity 10, right? It has three options. So how in the world do you know which one to pick? Here's my hint to you. Keep our eye on the prize. This is what we're trying to get it to be, right? Do you see any cosines over here? So when we change cosine of 2x, let's use identity number 10. Let's use the one that doesn't have any cosines in it. You with me? If you're trying to prove something, be smart about it. So yes, we have this. Let's not pick this or this. Let's pick that. 1 minus 2 sine x times sine x. Okay? So now, at this point, it's just algebra the rest of the way. Algebra the rest of the way. Let's just actually multiply these. Okay? So I have 2. What's cosine times cosine? It's going to be cosine squared plus 1 times sine is just sine x. And then negative 2 sine squared times sine would be negative 2 sine to the third. Right? Okay, you with me? And now we're just going to look for like terms. Do you see any? You see any like terms? No, don't see any like terms. So where am I going from here? Ah, what's messing us up? What do we want to get rid of?
Cosine.
So do we remember a way that we could change cosine into a sine? We just did it earlier. Let's change this guy into this. So let me highlight that. That's an identity, okay? That's an identity, okay? And notice how I accidentally put the 2 and the sine on opposite sides. They should be technically together, okay? It all means the same thing. They should be smushed together, just so you can do now our multiplication. So, different color here to draw my arrows. This times this, this times this. So 2 sine x times 1 is 2 sine x. Okay? 2 sine x times negative sine squared x is negative 2 sine to the third. And then over here, this hasn't changed. Okay? And from right here, now we have everything converted to sine. We're pretty much done. There's no more real thinking involved. You just have to look for like terms. Here's some, and here's some. And then there's the other two that can go together, right? So 2 sine x plus another sine x makes 3 sine x. I'm going to have to write it up here. And negative 2 sine third x minus 2 more sine third x would give you negative how many?
4.
Negative 4 sine 3 x. And this check out.